So the next arch we're going to look at is the flat cambered or Georgian arch. It's sometimes called a jack arch, but I'm not sure why it's called a jack arch. The three names that we have here are all self-explanatory because it is a flat arch. So it's the one with the flat intrados on it. Sometimes when we see these, they are often cambered on the bottom. Even if it's flat though, it should have a very slight camber. We'll go into this when I do the terminology for it. But for every meter, it should have a 10 mil camber or rise in it. Just to take the effect of the illusion of sagging out of it. But I tend to call this a Georgian arch because this was the period of time when this arch was used massively, extensively, and it did carry on for a little while, but obviously that's the period of where it was born. So flat cambered or Georgian, and it's quite simple to set out, but very difficult to build. Oh, well, maybe not to build, very difficult to cut the bricks. I'll go into that very, very soon. But the skewbacks are 60 degrees. So all we need to do is do two 60 degree abutments. And this is the striking point of our arch. Now, the shape of our arch, very simple. We can do this just by marking a flat intrados. We're going to be 3/4 high. Sometimes they are a little bit more than that, but generally speaking they are 3/4 high. So we'll do the flat extrados. Now our striking point is where we set all our bricks out from. So put the point in the striking point. I don't know if you can see that. Just there. And I will just open it up to our striking point there. Or springing point, I should say. And we have a very, very light arc. I am also going to draw a very faint center line because that does help when we're actually setting out to know how we're going halfway. Right, so I'm going to go to 75 mil for a brick, which is there, and I'm just going to gently run this out just to see where that comes on our center. And you can see it doesn't quite work. So what I'm gonna do is I am going to decrease it to get an extra brick in, because there's no way that you would want to open these joints up, because you're gonna be cutting very fine joints on this. And that's open up a touch, it is only a fraction. Very, very small. You see, I'm not marking anything with a pencil yet until I'm happy that these all work out. Oh, that is so close. That is so close. I am gonna go with that this time, because I'm happy with them. I will just put a little mark on each one and follow it right round to the other side as well. Now, with this arch, I've done a few of these, and you may have seen one or two of the videos that I've done, but they are the most difficult to mark out and cut, because every single brick is different. And when I go through this now with you, I'll just explain that as well. So now we're going from our striking point and drawing these all in. And again, it's worked nicely for a bonded arch because we have a key brick. Remember, if we don't have a key brick, you cannot bond the arch. Again, concentration keeps me quiet. And I do look forward to reading any comments that you have, good or bad, I don't mind. Now, I'm just going to point out a couple of things here now. So you can see that every brick has a different angle. So it's not like the segmental or the semicircular arch where you can just set up and get the angles radiating down, and then they're all the same. This one, because we've got two flat surfaces here and we're setting out on this curve, every single intrados and extrados angle changes, and every perp or bed joint, if you like to call them bed joints as well, will change as well. So every brick has four individual cuts on them. And that is very time consuming, but in my opinion, I think it's a really lovely arch, one of my favourite arches, to be honest. So I will just mark this all up in pen, and then we will go through the terminology again. So with the terminology, we will start again here. We have a 60 degree angle skew back, here we have the striking point again. If you remember, there was an arc that we set all these joints out on, so this is the striking point. And again, that was just 60 degree angle, and where they meet, obviously the center line will be the same there anyway. We turn this again into a bonded arch. They're not always like that, but I think bonded arches do look a little bit better. And again, as I emphasize all the time, that we need to have an odd number of bricks so that we get a key brick in there. And the other thing we said about the rise on this, although it's flat, there should be a 10 millimeter for every 1 meter. So 10 millimeter rise for every meter of span. And one thing I was going to just point out as well, I see this occasionally where the closures, if it's a 9-inch work, the closures carry on into the brickwork where the arch starts. That shouldn't happen. The closures should always stop where the opening stops. So where the brickwork starts to go across, there is no closures, because that obviously just reverts back to the wall that will be above as well. So closures stop at the head of the window, not into the arch. Okay, so that's terminology for that one. The next one we do will be a Gothic arch.